first. It's the four-seeded St. Francis Red Flash taking on the top-seeded regular season champions, the Quinnipiac Bobcats.
Your exclusive home for live updates of the NEC Men's Soccer Championship. Here's Byers driving into the 18, fires and scores! And there's that one goal off the left foot of Ryan Byers.
Actually, this time, I think it's quickly taking the corner. I think he's going to put it in.
He's going to send it into the box, looking for the header, and it's knocked away.
Played it into the box.
This will go into the 18 as well, looking for that back post. The shot will go wide.
Almost clear in on goal, but a good job by Quinnipiac recovering.
Here's Surprise. Surprise with the shot, and he scores! Surprise, surprise, it's Phillip Surprise with the equalizer.
That's the ninth goal of the season for Surprise, and he was played in beautifully.
A service over the far side, it's Tiller. Tiller looking for Byers on the corner of the 18, trying to fight off two defenders. Now it's one-on-one, the shot, it goes off the post. Ball still loose inside the six, and the Bobcats will be able to clear it.
We have a couple other players making runs as well. Surprise in the hole at times, and Byers has a chance.
Byers sends it in and just misses wide. He had it on the right foot, misses wide of that back post. Around and get loose, because again, there's semifinals coming up next. Off the right foot, looking for Nickel. It goes off the right foot, and it's saved by Valsacek. Sam Nickel was free. He had space. Berg, who has tallied 5 goals this year. Eighth in the Northeast Conference, a second-team all-conference performer. Kalaric for the win. Got it! And the St. Francis Red Flash are headed to the 2012 NEC Men's Soccer Championship game. An unbelievable, dramatic semifinal. After 110 minutes of regulation, and then especially here in penalty kicks. But in PKs, by the score of 4-3, it's St. Francis.
We're back here with Coach for St. Francis, who has won. His team has advanced to the conference final here on penalties in a hard-fought match. What are you feeling about the first 15 minutes of the second half after Quinnipiac tied it up? Looked like they had some momentum going there. Peppering the goal with shots. How did you feel in that spot?
Quinnipiac's a good team, and I mean, we knew that they were never going to stop. You know, they have a lot of good players, and they put us under a lot of pressure, especially with the wind coming at our faces that strong. They scored the goal, and it rattled us a little bit, but all season long, our guys have done a great job of handling adversity, you know, staying together, fighting together, and handling adversity, and they took that in stride, were able to get through the match, and win the game in penalties. It was a great job by the guys.
Now, we also have James Price with us, who was a rock at the back today for St. Francis. You went down with had a little bit of a nick there. How did it feel, you know, coming out, playing through that, you know, coming through so many defensive headers, just being all around at the back today?
I mean, yeah, it was a tough game. Quinnipiac are a physical side, and it was just winning that battle, because that's all it was out there. It was just a battle with the wind. Like, we knew we were going to be under the pump the whole half. So we just camped in our half, and we knew if we could just stick together and battle it out as a team, we'd do the job, and that's all it was, just knowing I had my teammates having my back. Yeah.
Now, looking forward to Sunday, Coach. Both these teams, both the Jersey teams, both have different skill sets, both pretty solid defensively. What do you look forward to from whichever team you may face?
You know, we're just happy to be able to play on Sunday. You know, I mean, we've been able to get past this one, and you know, give ourselves a chance to play for a championship. We know both FDU and Monmouth are both really good teams. It's going to take the best out of us to win that match. You know, so we're going to recover, we're going to enjoy this one, and get ready for Sunday.